a glow up.
Sob story, but make it educational.
Healing, but make it spicy.
Recovering from Lyme, Hashimoto's, and mold, but not in a creepy, I'm a guru type of way. Just sharing my story like a normal human being. With some science.
Buckle up. This is a long share. And yes, these are my blueberries. They're very abundant, but that's a story for a different time.
Many people are surprised to learn that I have been secretly sick for years, and that's because I'm very good at hiding stuff I'm dealing with and with being very particular with the things that I share about my life on the internet. But yes, I have been quite unwell for a long time with a lot of symptoms, and I used to think, you know what, nobody wants to hear that, that's just depressing, I'm not going to share about it. Turns out plenty of people benefit from learning about other people's healing processes. Who'd have thunk? So that's why I'm here. I'm here to share with you, and hopefully it will benefit you or someone you know in some way. Here's the tea, all the tea. As much tea as you could imagine. It's the friggin' Boston Tea Party over here. Lots of symptoms. Chronic pain, nausea, joint pain, muscle pain, so many that I actually like forget how many there have been. So here's just a list of all of the symptoms that I've experienced over the past 5-6 years, and they've just gotten worse and worse over time. Fun. As somebody who is very into health and wellness, this was all very disturbing because I eat super well, I exercise, I'm a yoga teacher, I do breath work, I meditate, you know, I do inner work. It's kind of shocking that I was going through so much of this and it was just getting worse. So I was kind of starting to freak out.
Game over.
For a minute there, I thought maybe I was dying.
I tried everything under the sun that I could personally think of to treat the symptoms that I was experiencing, from dry needling to physical therapy to Pilates-based exercise rehabilitation to trigger point therapy, supplements, shamanism, talk therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy. I mean, the list goes on. In summer of 2020, on top of everything else that was happening that year, we realized or figured out that our home had mold in it, and that was really impacting my health and was probably one of the underlying conditions that I was experiencing.
I actually remember it so vividly. I was at the beach in Virginia Beach, and my husband called me, and I was sitting on a bench down up by like 60th Street in the north end of Virginia Beach. And he called me and he was like, babe, I think that we have mold in our house and that's what's making you sick. And we both just started crying and feeling like, wow, maybe this is the thing that is causing me to have so many issues, because it had really taken over my life at this point. And I wasn't able to work or just have a regular life.
It wasn't a good time. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy, let me tell you that.
Anyway, I was doing a lot of throwing shit against the wall to see if it would stick kind of work. And I was making a little bit of progress, but not really enough to make a huge impact. And I finally found this functional medicine practitioner who I'll link down in my show notes. She just did a massive amount of tests on me. I mean, tons of different tests, my blood work and urine samples and all that jazz.
Data, maths.
I found out some very, very important information, which would change my life. Here is what science told me. I have chronic Lyme, Hashimoto's thyroiditis, mold toxicity or mold poisoning, EBV, which is Epstein-Barr virus, and there are a lot of varieties of those, one of them being mono, and dangerously low pancreatic enzymes. Who knows why? Well, functional medicine has more of a whole body approach to medicine, whereas allopathic or Western medicine tends to break up the body into different pieces. So a typical doctor will send you to a different specialist for different issues you're having. So if you're having skin issues, they'll send you to a dermatologist. If you're having gut issues, they'll send you to a special gut doctor. Or, you know, if you're having foot issues, they'll send you to a special foot doctor. And that was an issue that I was having. I have seen so many different specialists
were all giving me different pieces of information, but none of them were talking to each other. So you end up with this sort of gap in the system, which is very common for people with chronic mysterious illnesses like myself. So going the functional medicine approach made a lot more sense, since they're really interested in root cause. So what's actually causing all of these little symptoms that you're having? So you can get all the different pieces of the puzzle and start to see how they interlock and create or show the whole picture.
Plus, they're more likely to be conscious of natural alternatives like supplements and lifestyle and behavior factors, emotional factors to health and wellness. My functional medicine practitioner both can prescribe me medication, but can also recommend different lifestyle or behavior choices for me that can improve my conditions.
So that's what happened. I had a two hour long intake with my functional medicine practitioner, and she was like, yep, I have my suspicions. I'm not sure what it is, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna run a hell of a lot of tests on you. And I'm gonna link all of the tests that I actually had done with the labs that I actually worked with in the show notes, so you can go check that out. But it was really, really extensive. And let me tell you, it is cool to have data, man. Data is awesome. I ran my blood work through Quest Labs. I mold test through Great Plains Laboratories. And a nutrition panel through Genova Diagnostics called NutriEval. Treatment.
The hair today is really doing its thing. Hello. So I went on a 6-week antibiotic protocol with an antiviral at the same time. And that was super, super hard. I was incredibly nauseous throughout the entire treatment. I was throwing up a lot and it was tough, man. But I'm glad that I did it. That was specifically for the Lyme and trying to treat some of the mono at the same time. I also did a bunch of vitamin C IVs, which I found to be really helpful. My energy was so, so bad before I started them. And then it just was so much better after about the third IV. I'm also currently taking a series of ALA IVs, alpha-lipoic acid, for some of my ongoing neurological conditions. So hopeful that those will be as helpful as the vitamin C IVs were. And I'm also on a prescription medication for my mold detox called Wellcol. It's technically a cholesterol medication, but it does work to help detox mold out of the body. There's not a lot that will detox mold out of the body if you're someone like me who doesn't really detox it very well naturally. So it really helps to have some sort of prescription to help you with that. Morgan's dad walked by. Let's talk about some extra therapies and lifestyle choices that have helped me so much as I have been on this journey of recovery. 2 feet away, but here to stay. I'm talking Epsom salt baths with a lot of salt, 3 to 6 cups of salt per bath. Long soaks. I put a little bit of CBD oil into the bath when I'm soaking. Chef's kiss. So, so helpful. CBD taken internally is one of the most helpful things that I took for help when I was detoxing, and I still take it almost every day, not just for social anxiety, which it really helps for, but just for chronic pain or just general symptoms that I'm having. I typically will have like joint pain or muscle pain or like some muscle spasms or something, and it can just be so great. Bird, oh my God. Wow. Lymphatic drainage massage, so helpful. I had never had one before I was going through my detox. Lymphatic massage is amazing. It can really improve your immune system's response, and so your recovery time can be faster. Love that, love it. Big fan. What else can I do? Infrared sauna, amazing. I have an infrared sauna blanket that I think costs like $400 or $500, which is not nothing, but it's a lot cheaper than like a home sauna kit, which is like $3,000+ for a full home sauna. So I mean, it's a lot cheaper than the other thing, you know what I mean?
really helps with detox symptoms. For me, my body was having a really hard time actually detoxing everything that was in my body, from like the viral load and from the spirochetes, so the Lyme spirochetes. So the infrared sauna can be really, really helpful for that. And supplements. So I take turmeric supreme from Gaia Herbs, which I love. I also take grass-fed liver pills, which are really important for getting that like deep nutrition that is missing from a lot of our modern food system these days, and especially important if you're sick. I take an EPA and DHA supplement from Nordic Naturals. So it's an omega supplement, just a straight up oil, although I wish that I had the pills, honestly. The oil can be a little hard to swallow. I've also taken magnesium and vitamin D3 for forever, but I also wanted to mention Intramax, which is a supplement that I take, which is like a super vitamin, but it's a liquid, so you absorb it really, really easily. Super good, highly recommend if you want a really high quality super vitamin complex. Can we just appreciate my tripod for sitting out here today? Yeah, it's three pots stacked on top of each other. Yeah, I just balance the camera up here. Use what you got.
But did it work? Well, the short answer is yes. And the long answer is yes, but ... A lot of my symptoms are a lot better at this point. But there are still some things that I struggle with. I still have chronic headaches. Not as bad as they were. They're like a 2 on the pain scale as opposed to an 8, which is pretty disabling. I still have neck pain. I still have really, really tight muscles through here, but that might be unrelated. Just kind of more of a being super hypermobile postural thing that I just continue to work on in physical therapy and in Pilates and doing core work and that sort of thing. Still have jaw pain, which can also cause some of my headaches. But amazingly, my nausea is gone, which is incredible. And I really attribute that to the autoimmune paleo protocol, which I should have mentioned earlier, but I could actually do a whole video just on that by itself. It's an elimination diet. It's 4 to 6 weeks. And then you start to add things back in that you eliminated during that short period just to see what you might be responding to. And it's very well researched for autoimmune diseases, and I found it to be pretty incredible. I feel more normal on this diet than I have in years, which is crazy because, you know, I've been gluten-free, dairy-free, refined sugar-free for like so long, and this is actually making a difference. But we'll just, you know, pocket that for a different video another day. So in conclusion, it's all good, baby. Actually, it's not completely all good, but it's mostly all good, baby. So yeah, things are better. I'm on the up and up. I'm healing, I'm moving forward. I'm still doing a lot of self-care. I'm still taking it super easy when it comes to putting a lot of work on my plate and making sure that my stress levels are like zero, basically, or very, very low, as low as possible, while I'm still in the recovery process.
Test, don't guess. Find yourself somebody who will get you all of the real data that you need to know what the heck is going on, because your intuition is not going to guide you in the right direction. I'm sorry, it's just not. I thought that I had one thing or five things, and I mean, I was right about the mold thing, but I would not have guessed the other things. So just make sure you get yourself somebody who will actually do all of the tests. Rely on your support systems. Super important. Make sure that you have a therapist or you have somebody who is very, very wise who you can talk to, or you can talk to your parents, or you can talk to a pet, or you have a partner who can support you emotionally during this difficult time. Support systems are everything. I would not have made it through without my incredible husband and his family and my family. It just, there's nothing to replace it. It's just so important. So anyway. Food is a powerful medium for recovery, but it's not the only thing. It's just one slice of the pie. The health pie is very large, and this is just one small but incredibly important part. So make sure you nourish yourself well. Just know that
there are other pieces to this puzzle. Okay, I'm gonna go make some guac. Hope you have a lovely evening. Leave your questions in the comments. Be nice. Be nice to each other. Love yourself well. I'll talk to you soon.
We'll call it Sicko Glow Up.